Hello dear colleagues, I am Dr. Galin Gavrilov and I'm orthodontist from Sofia. Recently I come across to a question: how can we turn a CBCT scan into a printable STL file? Well, a few time ago I have encountered this problem and I looked for a solution everywhere on the web, on YouTube, but there wasn't quite a lot of special for dentists and orthodontists like me stuff that can be used for printing. So I've learned a lot about that by using a few 3D scanners and CBCT scans. I went a few courses, learned a lot from using Onyx-CEF by Dr. Ludwig. So today I'd like to show you what I have come across, and this was for me the easiest way to turn a CBCT scan into a printable STL. Okay, the first thing that you need is a free software called Slicer. You see here the shortcut, I suppose, and you can download it from a web site that they have. It's called, if you write just Slicer, it would come across the into Google, and this is the website that you can download it. There are a lot of free resources there, a lot of YouTube videos how you should use and what you can do, but it's not very user friendly. So just download the latest version, start it with double clicking. I'm on Windows. I suppose that it looks the same on Mac, but when you open the main screen, you need a DICOM file or the DICOM directory. When you click here on the data, you choose directory or file to add. Well, in my case, it came from Romexis, and I have downloaded from the laboratory. I have named the file supernumerary 1-2, and you just click and open. It comes here that it's marked, and you click OK. Then the CBCT scan loads up and it comes. Okay, here on the blue screen that is up there, you don't see nothing yet. If you go up here, you see here the drop down menu and click on volume rendering, you will find these displays and text here on the left side. There is an eye, a closed eye here. If you click it, you will see the rendering of the volume that is in the CBCT scan. If you click the middle mouse button where the scroll is and hold it, you can move around. With the scroll you are coming up, make it bigger or smaller. Well, you see now the soft tissue and the hard tissue and the teeth and the bone in the scan. We don't need all that stuff in all the cases. In this case exactly, we have a supernumerary tooth here, which is quite big, between the right and the central and the right lateral incisor. You see, the point of this for me now is to discover if this supernumerary incisor is able to replace the lateral incisor, which is here. You see here the radix, the root of the lateral incisor is messing with the canine and it may not erupt or even be resorbed by the eruption of the canine. So the point for my looking at this scan is to think if it is proper, if it would be okay to replace the lateral right incisor, which is very under the canine, the right canine here is the lateral incisor, the normal one, with this supernumerary lateral incisor, which is here. So, when this one here, in order to see if that's possible, usually I need to print the model to see if it looks good enough, and to show to the parents if they can manage with that, to keep this deformed incisor or to extract it and move the lateral incisor, which is the normal one under the canine, to to the normal position, which is very risky in some cases and may lead to root resorption. So now I will show you how, when you open the DICOM file, the DCM here, how to crop it, how to make few adjustments to be ready to directly put it to the lab for printing, or even use a FDM printer to print the model, the cast, the teeth and the bone of the patient. So when you open like that and you see the volumes here, you just go here up in the fine model and open the menu when you just write crop. When you write crop, you see the crop volume. Click it and click switch to model. Now when you open the this crop module, you need to see the display, the points of interest around click fix, and they all come here when you click display points of interest. Now it's the time to move the slider and the points around about the zone that you are interested in, that you need to check how it's fitting. When you get up here to the slider and move around, you see moving around if everything that you need to see is in the area of your interest. So I think that that's enough on this here window. We're going to the lower window. We don't need that empty space down here. Here, and we check like moving around if everything that I need to see is there. Yes, the incisors are in here, and then I will put just apply, and everything will crop to this area that is of my interest here that I've marked. This marked area now is the only area that I need, but in this scan now we have a lot of soft tissue, we have a lot of noise from the scan, and a lot NT down under this. To make them visible, you go again here to the drop-down menu and click on the segment editor. The segment editor is the way that you can divide teeth from the bone or even from the airways. How that is gonna happen? You just click on add here, add new empty segment, and the segment that it's coming is the segment that you are gonna edit. There is a threshold button here. You just click on it. The threshold button opens and everything become greenish around. You see here this slider. The left one is marking the way of the hard tissue that would be visible. The right side slider is bone and the soft tissues and the air that you may remove by moving that. You may remove the teeth and allow only airways and the bone to stay. But I need the teeth now, so I will try to remove the air, the soft tissues and the bone, at least a little. So I'm getting this left slider and moving in around to get at least to 1000. The 1000 is a value here when the teeth are in green and some of the bone. So there would be some of the bone visible and a lot of teeth. I will see the teeth and the roots. If you mark it like that and move the slider here above the any part of the screen, you will see how the teeth are marked with green. The marked with green stuff would be visible on our saved file that we're gonna do now. So I've marked here on 1150 around. I haven't moved the right slider because I need the values of the teeth to be visible. And the only thing that I will do, will click apply. When you apply, you have here an arrow. This arrow, you can click the arrow and go to export files. And it would ask you where you'd like to save it. You don't click anything, just export. When you click just export, it will go to the directory that is marked as your exportation folder. It's called segmentation segment 1, as you can see here. The segment 1 is the name. And when you start it, if you have a free software like a Meshmixer, for example, that I'm using a lot, it would open the file that you have cropped and the things that you have let from the initial CBCT scan. Now, what we have here, we have the teeth and we have some of the bone. If you don't need some of the bone, you can remove it, you can edit, you can crop, you can mark with the tools. It's not the point for me now to explain how you can use the mesh mixer. You can cut parts, you can do whatever you know want, you can sculpture, but it doesn't matter really for this point of this demonstration. The point is that you see the visible both lateral incisors, and when I print them, I can be able to show them to the mother to think if the crown is good enough for this one that is between the lateral and the center here, this one here. So the other thing that you should do to click analyze inspector tool, and the software will check if there are flaws in the STL mesh that you can repair. When I do repairs like that, it's very fast. You just click smooth fill, auto repair, and you'll calculate and fill up the defects. So the file to become printable. Now, this is repaired mesh structure that can be printed. And just click up here to export. Export. You need to export the file to the STL. It's called STL. And just write the name. For the example, it would be supernumerary 1-2, and it would be exported where you have placed it. It's in my downloads now. You maybe see it, supernumerary 1-2 STL, which is this file. In order to put it to the FDM printer like mine, that I will use for that purpose, you should open a software that is connected. Ultimaker Cura is my favorite for that, where you have to choose your kind of printer that you're using and other stuff here. It's not the point now to explain that, but just open the file that you would like to print and put it there. When you're ready with that, just you need to level it around a bit. Sometimes it's better to put it with the teeth up, at least for me, because the teeth would be the most important part to show to the mother. I usually use adhesion, which is a part on the bed of the printer that makes it not movable around, and supports, which will build up to make the model more solid. Then I will remove them. Usually the infill is about 10% for me, and it's not very detailed for now. It's 0.2 millimeters of the slices. And when I'm ready for that, I just click slice, and the software would make the file that should go to the printer directly by Wi-Fi or by the SD card or flash drive. So when it's ready, I just put it in the printer and start printing. Usually such kind of parts take about 6-7 hours to be printed on my printer. It's 5 hours now. And just click save to disk. It will ask you where to be saved. I'll say to downloads again just to see them all. And this is the file supernumerary G code for the printer. That is the STL that I get and the segmentation of the CBCT that I put in the mesh mixer. So one more thing that I'd like to show, just to make a difference between the files that you will get if you change the threshold in the segmentation in the editor. You see here, if you click segment and move this to the left, I will have a lot of bone there. And now if I click apply again, the segmentation would be in this part of it would be with more bone, the green stuff around the teeth. I will click export and find it again in the same name in the folder that you have chosen to be. Well, that's the name. Again, it's the same name right here, but it's different file now. When I open it, it will take a little bit more time because you have more mesh here to be opened, because the bone is taking a lot of memory for the file. When it comes live, you see now how much different it is. You see, you have a lot of noise, you have soft tissue, air and stuff. And this is the when the threshold is low here on 250. But if it's around 1100, the file that you get is without this noise and just the solid soft tissue. Again, I will show you what we got the last time to just make a difference. This is with the noise where you are about 200, and when you go to 1000 of the threshold, you will see the file very clearly, the teeth, only the teeth. You even can remove the bone at all, but you should be careful not to remove part of the roots also with going too up with the threshold. So there is a noticeable difference. Thank you for watching, and I hope that it will be useful for you in your practice. Thank you.